sine. It's a trigonometry function which is occasionally useful in game development. Defined as the ratio of the opposite hypotenuse sides for a given angle in a right angle triangle, it's an interesting problem how to actually calculate this. In this video, I look at various ways of calculating sine, as well as their performance and accuracy. Where to start? Well, in C++, the standard library contains std sine, a way to calculate sine for various floating point types. As this is the implementation I would normally reach for first, I will consider this the baseline, i.e. we will compare all other implementations against this. So there are two parts to this experiment, performance and accuracy. For performance, we want to time calculating a lot of values. There's an interesting property of floats. If you bitcast them to an unsigned integer, add one, and bitcast them back, you get the next smallest representable float. This means there are 2 to the 32, or just over 4 billion floats, so we'll test them all. To measure the accuracy, we will calculate sine at small fixed intervals between 0 and 2π, which represents a typical range of input values for sine, as well as not producing too many data points. For each experiment, I will then plot the difference against the baseline calculation. This will allow us to visually inspect the accuracy, as the more the plot moves away from 0, the less accurate the calculation was. So the first method I looked at was doing the calculation in assembly. x86, or more specifically, the x87 floating point subset of x86, has an fsin instruction. So I coded this up in a function, and the results were interesting. As we can see, it produces different values to our baseline, and that difference is dependent on the input value. Also, it was much slower. The accuracy discrepancy is pretty small, and according to the Intel manual, is probably due to the limited representation of pi internal to the CPU. The reason for the performance discrepancy is somewhat harder to quantify, but anecdotal evidence from various online discussions suggests that the hardware trig functions have not kept pace with other CPU advancements, which means they can be outperformed by a software solution. Next up was the classic textbook way of approximating sine, Taylor series expansion, or to be more precise, Maclaurin series expansion, as we are centered around zero. This is just a series of polynomials defined by this equation, and every time you add a new term in the series, you get a more accurate approximation. I implemented a few of these, and you can see the accuracy increases as well as the runtime. The most interesting one was the single term expansion, which just returns the input. Unsurprisingly, just returning the input value was much faster than doing any calculation, but what is surprising is how accurate it is for inputs close to zero. Another mathematical approximation method is Chebyshev polynomials. This is a similar idea to the Taylor series, but from my limited experimentation proved more accurate and efficient. In addition to these methods, there are also compiler flags that influence speed and accuracy. Specifically, for fast math on GCC like compilers and FupFast on MSVC. These tell the compiler to play fast and loose with the rules for the sake of efficiency. To save turning this into a school PowerPoint presentation with thousands of graphs, I took these test options, crunched the numbers, drew the graphs, and did the analysis. And the final answer is... Turns out std::sin is really good as a general purpose solution, although if you know the range of your inputs and are happy to sacrifice some accuracy, you might be able to beat it. This might be a bit anticlimactic, so let's look at the magic inside the glibc implementation to see what we can learn. It basically breaks the input down into ranges and picks an appropriate implementation based on that. Funnily enough, for really small values, it just returns the input value, which is what we saw in our experiment. It then uses a combination of Taylor series and lookup tables. One last thing I wanted to look at was calculating sine and cosine of the same value. x86 has a single instruction which can do both of these, so I wanted to see if that was any faster than calling std::sin and std::cos separately. Well, it turns out that it's not always possible to be faster by writing it in assembly. This was a fun jolly through some trigonometry in a not too rigorous way. The code is on GitHub, although currently only for Linux, and I was running all this in WSL. Let me know in the comments if you get different results, or if you know of another way of calculating sine. I know I didn't really look into lookup tables, as I was more interested in actually calculating the values. If you enjoyed this and want to see how I made the same game in assembly, C and C++, then check out this next video.